Control settings.
Welcome, student. Today, we have to learn the Coulomb's law in vector form. We have already seen that Coulomb's law in scalar form. Now, we want to see in vector form. For that, first up here, we want to take the two electrical charge. Suppose here, if we consider, this will be the first electrical charge, right? Which is placed at the point is there A, right? Now, this will be the second electrical charge, which is placed at the point is there B, right? Now, this will be the second charge is there simply Q2. Again here, both the charges are there positive. Both the charges are there positive. And again, both the charges which is separating by the distance is there simply R12. R12 represents the distance between the first and second electrical charge. Right? Then, here, the first electrical charge which adds the force on the second electrical charge. And again, both the charges are there like charges, that is positive, positive charge. So that's why. Here, when the charge Q1 which adds the force on the second one, then at that time, the direction of that force is there simply outward. That is along the direction AB. So here, this will be the force. Which one? Force acting on the second charge by the first one. Right? F21 stands for there force acting on the second charge by the first one. Right? Now, at the same time, the second charge which also adds the force on the first one as per the Newton's third law. Every action has equal and opposite reaction. So as per that here, second charge which also adds the force on the first one, and again the direction of that force which is also in outward direction. So this will be the force acting on the first charge by the second one. Right? Then, now here, we want to represent the units vector. See here. Here, the unit vector for this force is, what to get there? That is along the AB. Here, this will be the unit vector from first charge to the second charge. Here, R12, here cap represents the unit vector. So this will be the unit vector from first charge to the second charge. That is along the AB. Similarly, for the force F12, again, this will be the unit vector. Unit vector R21. It means that this will be the unit vector from second charge to the first charge, right? Second to the first charge along the direction BA, right? Now, first of here, we want to write down the specification of all the symbols. Here, first of here, F12 represents the force acting on the first charge by the second one. Force acting on first charge, that is a Q1 by Q2. Right? Similarly, F21, which is written as, what you get there? force acting on charge Q2 by charge Q1. Right? Similarly, unit vector. So unit vector is R12. Here, unit vector from charge Q1 to charge Q2. Similarly, here unit vector R21 represents the unit vector from charge Q2 to charge Q1. Right? And again here, one of the quantities there, R12. Here R12, only their magnitudes. It means that R12 represents the distance between the charge Q1 and charge Q2. Distance between the charge Q1 to Q2. Distance between the Q1 to Q2. Right? Now, this is the specifications which is utilized for vector form of the Coulomb's law. Right? Here, we want to write down the equation for the force F21 and force F12. Now, first of all, we want to write down the force F21. So, the force F21, which is written as. Here, the constant is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0. Here, epsilon 0 represents the permittivity of a free space. It means that these two electrical charges, which is placed in a air medium. But suppose here, instead of air medium, if you take in general term, that is, these electrical charges, which is placed in a medium, then at that time, here we want to write down simply epsilon. So what you get there? 1 upon 4 pi epsilon. Then here charge Q1, charge Q2 upon distance is there simply R12. Right? And now this will be the bracket square. But again, to the LHS side we get the vector. Again here we want to write down the vector. So that's why here, to this quantity, we want to multiplying by the unit vector. Here, the unit vectors along the direction AB, that is along the direction of force, that is F21, is simply R12. So here we get the unit vector R12. Similarly, we want to write down the second force, that is force acting on a first charge by the second one, which is equal to the. Again, we want to write down the same value. That is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon. Then charge Q1, Q2 upon distance is R12 bracket square. Here R12 is the distance between the first and second electrical charge. Right? That is R12. So this will be the only in terms of the magnitude. So here we get the square term. Then now here we want to write down the unit vector. Right? So the unit vectors along the F12 is simply there, R21. So here we want to write down there, unit vector R21. Right? So this will be the unit vector from second to first charge. This will be the unit vector from first to second charge. But here, this will be the force acting on a second charge by the first one. This will be the force acting on the first charge by the second one. Right? Now here, if we see the unit vector, that is unit vector R12 and unit vector R21. Here, their magnitude is same, simply 1. But their directions are opposite. Here the direction of R12 is along AB, but the direction of R21 is simply BA. It means that magnitude is same and their directions are opposite. But, what you get there? But, unit vector R12, which is equal to the minus of unit vector R21. It means that the magnitude of both the vectors are their same, only their directions are opposite. If the magnitude of unit vectors are same, only their directions are opposite, then if we substitute this value here, then what we get there? Here, the magnitude of these two forces, which are also same, only their directions are opposite. Right? So therefore, force F12, which is equal to the minus of F21. It means that the magnitude of both the forces are same, only their directions are opposite. Right? So this is about the vector form of the Coulomb's law. It means that we write down this electrostatic force in terms of the vectors. See all the equations once.